Yeah, it's the economy. He's just so tight into the next ball.
从三比四到六比四，奥沙利文又一次三连胜传奇，完成自己七冠称王路上最难的一次逆风翻盘。
Well, it's food back in the lead, 4-3.
光从比分表面上看似一面
倒战，
可实际比赛过程却是步步惊心。比如，你看这才刚开打，奥沙利文就上刺刀。
Thank you. That's enough, please.
反倒给了傅家俊抢的先机。
Looks quite a thin snick, this, but maybe he's okay.
One.
Restricted now to what he can do with the cue ball.
Level with the pink, he'd love to have a natural angle in the blue to be able to cannon that full ball, knowing the position would take care of itself.
可是 马科夫万万没想到，自己这一杆中带会失误。
Just a little bit of movement.
原本打算给自己做好的入局一杆，就彻底
成了。Just had a brilliant movement in his body there in that shot. That wasn't his normal smooth playing style.
One. Seven.Eight.
Yeah, more difficult.
才吃下两套红彩球，他救国敢炸球。
16.
他想以牙还牙，学学傅家俊上一局那样，带住时机就一杆制胜。
24. Set. 31.
我见这手感，真的是太好了。
Canning that red there.
简化局面能力确实也很强。
Again, the three reds above the black leave one to the left corner.
最后又顺势一 K.
That's what he's played.
看一下这一杆能否带出进攻的球。运气很
大。When he hits this red, it leaves the cue ball to keep going through, and leave one of those reds to the left corner.
As we know what happened
in the previous round. 这一记中带红球，得考验他的准度了。
Oh, what a shot!
Run through the gap, the red to the right, the pink.
又是底带黑球。顺带一顶，再次盘活一红球了，接着又随心所欲的，又一次轰炸，真是彪悍。但一个不小心把自个彩球的球路堵死了。那就防守开路。
And the brown near the cushion has a little bit of insurance.
这下子，玩的真是死死。
Not with a man in the form that Marco Fu is.
傅家俊，这一杆破解也真够巧妙啊
！Very clever indeed. Acknowledged by Ronnie Tappan on the table.
And 奥沙利文这一杆推顶薄球，反而是出问题了。
Didn't want the cannon on the brown.
傅家俊迎来翻盘机会，
no,
上手很巧。
Look how confidently he played that.Just floated it in. He's just seen everything, Dennis, hasn't he? Oh. Decelerated on that.
Yep.
Wow, that could have been a huge turning point.
One.
Just so evenly matched now in this semi-final.
清脆拿下超分球，并趁机热身练球。
Yes, he would have been a strong favorite had he have taken the frame, but you just sense that this could go to a deciding frame. We've won quite a few.
28. 29.
Yeah, an average frame time of under 12 minutes. That's
36.
Just shows you.
41.
完成一杆清台，重新积攒了足够的进攻自信。
He finished the frame off with a break of 63.
到了天王山的一局，双方都谨慎开局。
Once again, good pace with the break-off shot. He might just be tempted.
傅家俊甚至不惜放弃了这次进攻尝试。
That he'd play, but now that as Hazel said, it's not.
白球薄边，绕库沉底，
risking that and
稳妥的做了这一杆精妙安全球。
Closest to the cue ball, he can come the black into play as well.
比拼防守，奥沙利文 也不胆怯，仅凭一颗黄球遮挡，就完美做了一番漂亮的防守反击。傅家俊选择了贴球堆破解，可力度。
Yeah, so you can come off the bunch on the thin end. It's not that difficult a shot.
It's
to take the cue ball back up to where he was playing from.
蹭球堆后，轻轻一滑，留下进攻缝隙。
Judges.
奥沙利文带出这点瑕疵。
Yeah, it was the first thin of the bunch and brought the cue ball back up the table.
又上手了，进入节奏的他。
Not the way he's been playing so far this afternoon. That shot.
每次出杆都那么丝滑流畅，那如诗如画的进攻。就像拆解一件精密的艺术品。
A cannon here when he hits the black.
而白球就像他指缝中精灵。
Could a left? I mean, to get that shot.
无比精确的在台面游走，不断在寻找最合适的走位路线，然后把每一颗目标球稳稳送入袋口去。虽然贵为台球最具天赋的球员，但他暴烈的脾气几乎没半点不拖泥带水的出杆速度，也注定了他也比较容易在阴沟里翻车。好比这一杆，他就失去了进攻的连贯机会，得防守了。对手虽然手握46分的优势，但台面还有整整九颗红球呢，傅家俊还有机会翻盘。所以他炸裂一杆贴咖啡球的后斯诺。
Very awkward cueing。
考验考验胡老师，奥沙利文也是个狠人，红球送中袋口，白球却被红球堆起死回
城。Situation he was faced with there。
双方连续轰出神仙球，让现场球迷们忍不住大呼过瘾。
If that red keeps running, he's safe, or relatively safe. And he got away with that one.
当然，这一杆若傅家俊要强攻，还是有机会的。
Pot.
比如白圈那只红球，可傅家俊还是不想冒险。
Just the safety shot. Don't blame him.
又博弈了。几杆安全球后
，Oh, we've had bouts of safety, and now we're getting that.
傅家俊的这一杠打带跑的组合球，
oh,
不管是进攻方面
advantage,
还是防守方面，都完美做到他想要的结果。
Plant.
但这两个都好了，
ball,
反而就让他尴尬。
Yeah, get too cute.
他选择了白球轻撞咖啡。
Oh, that cue ball ran off. Watch this cue ball go to the right.
想一杆斯诺克开路。
That's shocking.
没料到这力度没把控好，捅篓子了。奥沙利文趁机一杆远台，二次上手了。
Marco Fu could have done about that. Sometimes you get it along the balk line. He can't make his mind up.
来回几杆，局面又被他拆解的明明白白了。
A long way behind, but how do you going in?Fantastic stuff. I think that
got to him.
28.
不得不说，火箭这手感真的是太好了。
37. 44.
简化局面能力更是强得让人喘不过气。
55 and 63. Pattern.Breaks of 46 and now this.
55.
又是一杆轻台，然后五比四抢先获得赛点局。
And the blacks in as well. We have break of 46. The rocket really has lifted off, and now he's just one frame away from a place in the final. It's 5-4.Noise when it's needed, silence when the players are at the table.
Beat 到绝境时刻，傅家俊也打出自己的血性了，直接轰炸球堆。白球回顶，
well,
是要与胡老师一杆分高低。
It's okay.
这一杆很要紧，火箭格外谨慎小心。
Certainly.No easy escape back down the table from that position.
一番仔细研究后，他找准了白球逃脱的路线。
It's very understandable here.
就霸气一杆远台尝试，漂亮！红球入杆，白球
it was worth waiting on. Andy's on the ground.
为他喝彩叫好，然后是咖啡球调教。白球再次杀入红球堆。
Now looks odds on.
看一下这一杆他能不能找到舒适位置。
Settling himself, he knows the importance of this visit.
还是未能入局。
Six.
那就继续顶戴低分彩球，调教一下。接着是复位粉球，就这两下子，下半区的红球，瞬间就有了入局的支撑点了。
31.
奥沙利文的火力筒子瞬间也被点燃了。
It's been an absolutely
37.
fabulous semi-final match this. The top of their form.
围绕粉蓝两球，
Very few mistakes have been made. It was costly because
the will to win is ferocious at the moment.
This is going to finish a little awkward.
也没关系，他强行
就对。It's there.
没想放过去。丝滑流畅的火力输出，让傅家俊都忍不住。
We said Marco Fu would have to play at the top of his game. That's the type of character that Marco is.
看得出火箭打的也是非常认真。
To some brilliant, brilliant snooker.
Sullivan, that is lovely to see both players. Fabulous semi-final. It would have graced any final.